I want this to be a greetings telegram.
A shilling, please.
When will it arrive, please?
1:30. It should be there by 2.
Thank you.
In Britain, 1 million telegrams are sent every week. To keep pace with this enormous traffic, the post office has installed time-saving machinery wherever possible. The telegrams go directly from the counter to the instrument room. Here they are transmitted by the teleprinter, over the telegraph wires, to any part of the country. This girl's teleprinter is connected by an electric cable to the Bournemouth office. She taps out the message letter by letter on this keyboard. By overhead wire and underground cable, it is carried hundreds of miles to the distant teleprinter. When a key is struck, the transmitter switches an electric current in the cable on or off 5 times. These changes in the current are arranged differently for each letter, forming a sort of code. For example, the code for Y is first on, second off, third on, fourth off, fifth on. The teleprinter is really 2 instruments under one cover. A transmitter and a receiver. This is a transmitter. Here it is as a simplified model. And here is a simplified model of a receiver. The transmitter is joined by the electric cable to a receiver hundreds of miles away. The telegram message is sent over this cable by means of the code, which starts in the transmitter as a combination of these 5 bars. We've colored the bars so as to identify them. This is the code for letter R, for example. For S, the green and orange bars move forward. Through the cable goes the code for S. As it reaches the receiver, the code is reset up in these arms. The green and orange arms are raised. Compare them with the bars in the transmitter. Now the code for R. Yellow and blue move forward. The code for R is reset up in the receiver. The yellow and blue arms are lifted. But first of all, how is the code set up in the transmitter? These bars extend right along the keyboard. Across the top of the bars, parallel with each key, is a row of projecting teeth. Suppose the letter S is struck, we see it move down onto the bars. Springs pull the bars to the right, but the key stops some of the bars from moving. The code for S is set up. Instantaneously, it is set up in the receiver also. It is carried to the receiver by overhead wire and underground cable in the form of the 5 changes of current which make up the code. These operate the magnet in the receiver. Through levers, the magnet raises or lowers this red oscillating blade. When the current is on, the blade is raised. When the current is cut off, the blade is lowered. If the blade is lowered, it passes under this pin. If it's raised, it strikes the pin and pushes over the finger opposite. The current switches off. The blade is lowered and passes under the pin. This finger is not moved. Each change of current sets up the corresponding finger. The fingers are raised and set up the code for S in these five arms, just as it was in the transmitter. So that the letter can be transmitted, the pattern in the fingers must be turned into the electric code by the transmitting switch. Each of these revolving discs has a scoop cut out of it. The scoops come to the top, one after the other. That means that these five fingers which rest on the discs are let down one by one as the discs revolve. As each finger falls, it works the switch. But the code set up in the bars stops some of the fingers from falling. This is the code for Y. Only the fingers which fall switch on the current. White on, yellow off, green on, blue off, orange on. These changes of current in the cable operate the magnet in the receiver. The corresponding fingers are set up in the code for Y. White in, yellow out, green in, blue out, orange in. The arms are moved into the code. All that remains to be done is to use the code to select the corresponding letter. That is done inside this barrel. The revolving wheel is called the type wheel. It carries all the letters ready for printing. The type wheel stops in a certain position because this revolving arm strikes against one of these latches, one that has been selected by the code. Right inside the barrel of latches are the decoding discs which select the latch corresponding to the code. The latches rest on the edges of these discs, like this. They don't fall into the slots because the slots are all out of line. It takes exact adjustment to bring a row of slots into line. Some discs are turned, others kept still. The whole series of operations of the code reaches its climax in this final adjustment. The fingers are set up in the code. They raise some of the arms, which turns some of the discs, and a row of slots comes into line. This allows a latch resting on the discs where the row is brought into line to drop into the slots. The revolving arm will strike the latch and stop the corresponding letter in the printing position. Let us test the machine. Press down letter A. The code is set up in the bars. Blue and orange move forward. It is turned into changes of current in the cable. The changes of current work the magnet and reset up the blue finger and the orange finger, which turn the blue and orange discs, and a latch falls, stopping the type wheel at letter A. In this way, each code is turned back into its letter. Letter by letter, the message is printed onto this tape. Its electrical journey is over.
Ready for dispatch, Doris.
8 minutes since it was handed in.
You'll be back at 2:30.
What a house.